Hello fellas, this is your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to have a blast. Like literally to have a blast, spit on the enemies and have a good time. Today we are going to play with a 1357. I have one epic battle for you. When I'm saying epic, it means epic. Everything has done, everything what I done was very, very good, and we score very, very high base experience. Maybe it's even highest base experience in the Russian server, but I'm not entirely sure. So it's going to be a good one, and couple of very, very high damage games. This tank can do that, and it has a potential. I market this vehicle up to 100%. And I was struggling with it. I was shooting full gold, and that was the part of the deal, if you remember the video which I have made before, like 1 month or 2 weeks or 3 weeks, I don't even know. Pretty much how the things is looking like. We market this tank with a full gold, and this vehicle we are going to mark with this loadout, up to 100%. As you can see, 3/5 is the APs and 2/5 are the APCR, so it's going to be significantly higher to do this stuff instead of spamming the full gold, and we will compare average performance. And with this tank, we managed to go up to 100% in 211 battles, which is a lot. We managed to get 1,900 damage, which is very good, and 1,300 spotting damage, right, which is also extremely good for a tier 7 segment. And in order not to drop down, hold your bananas, in order not to drop down with a tier 7, we need a 3,300. Yes, only 3.3. If we want to raise up like 0.2% of mark of excellence, we needed like over 4,000, and it's not easy to do, fellas. It is a tier 7 after all. As an example, majority of the tier 8s do not have the expectation values like this, so it was very, very interesting. Anyways, fellas, let's go right into the battles and let's have some fun, shall we? Let's go. And we are back, fellas. We are starting everything with a Harry Potter map, which is Prokhorovka. When we are streaming, we are rolling with a Harry Potter song right here, right? So here we go. Uno momento, let me put on the color blind mode. Yep, we are ready to go. So this battle is one of the best battles. Actually, this is the best battle which I had with this vehicle, speaking about the base experience wise. It's not 1.5, it's not 1.7, it's not 1.9. You will see what kind of score we are going to get there. And I completely understand there is some people which is upset about the gold ammunition in the World of Tanks and so on, but in my opinion, this is the right way how to play with this vehicle. It's just created for that, and I had a truly blast playing with this tank. Obviously, when we reached 97% of the mark of excellence, then I was struggling quite a bit. Then I was crying quite a bit, and so on, so on. But it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. Now, stop for a second. Pay attention what is happening in this matchmaking. I mean, holy bananas from banana land. Look at what our team is doing. As you can see, there is a bunch of people which is in 1-2 line. There is two guys which is over there, and there is one light in the middle. There is not a single tank which is doing damage from the middle. So this is going to be quite hard battle, and you are going to see everything yourself. So first of all, we are getting into the bush ideally, but Vaza is getting spotted. What we are doing, we are using auto aim on Vaza, and we are trying to smack him a couple of times. But as you can see, Vaza is not afraid, and he is going for his life right here. He is making a hardcore pressure, and he is saying, "Skill, you mother trucker, you are going to die." And I'm running from this guy like there is no tomorrow, and he is saying, "Skill, you still mother trucker, you will die." He managed to penetrate me with a high explosive right here, and I'm saying, "Noob team!" I'm crying in the corner with this, but luckily this guy is defeated, and we are down to 200 hit points. Disgusting start of this battle. 2 minutes in, we only managed to get 600 damage DLT and 400 assisting damage. Plus on top of that, we lost pretty much all of our hit points. But we are not complaining too much, because we still have a hope, we have a plan, we have a dream, okay? And when we have a dream, I can tell you that we will fight for our dream with our nails, with our teeth, and with our even our red ass, okay? That's how we are going to fight for. So First things first, fellas, we are trying to return into this bush over there. Why so? Because we want to outspot every single person which is playing around this area. That's super important. And if we will be able to outspot them, then life is going to be bloodyful. As you can see, the T-34-100 is getting spotted right here, and I'm going even higher into the bush right here because I will get closer so I can outspot them way more easily, right? Extra meters there, extra meters there, you get the point. I mean, my view range on this tank is great, but it is closer I'm going to be for an enemy, is better chance I have to outspot them. Simple as this. Meanwhile, enemy art is getting spotted, and enemy art is trying to run for his life, and I'm saying, not today, mother trucker, not today. Not today, I said. Beautiful. This guy is getting slaughtered, and now we are trying to eliminate the T-34-100 from the game. Since we managed to do that 3 minutes into the battle, we have 800 damage dealt, and we have 1,300 assisting damage, which is very good. So what we want to do now, we want to think about repushing this side over there. We want to check out who is living on top of the hill, what kind of birds are living here, because it's super duper hyper turbo important, don't you think so? And soon we will need to provide some assisting damage to the 1-2 line if we want to get some use. Meanwhile, I moved a bit backwards, but I did not manage to find a good angle for IS over there, and I know time is ticking. If I want to do something, I need to relocate, and I'm immediately relocating from over there. I'm checking, am I going to get spotted from someone on top of the hill? And since it wasn't the case, what we are going to do, we are going to approach the enemy IS from a bit different direction. Why so? Because he is blind as a pigeon, and he cannot see anything. Meanwhile, we are taking this bush over there just to check it out. What is happening around? And his enemy is doing something bad or not? I'm speaking about that IS. If he would try to escape, I would definitely outspot him. Since he is not, we are immediately one step ahead, and we are moving towards this line of the bushes in front. Why so? Because our goal is to spot this IS and in the same time shoot him. Why do we want to spot him, and why do we want to shoot him? The thing is, we have 3 pigeons, we have 3 artists, we have 3 Jeffs, which could be a great help for us. Meanwhile, IS is getting spotted in the bushes right here. Luckily, we are playing with a light tank and he can't see us. So what we are thinking about crafting the double bush so we can start shooting him, right? Over there, I'm thinking about it, 314 meters, yeah, it's such a complicated situation, so I'm trying to run a bit further away, because I can build a bit of the distance, and since this guy just shot, I am actually thinking about starting clipping him even without using the bushes right here, as you can see, trying to work with my gun depression or gun elevation, and now we are rolling. 2 out of 3 so far, not too bad. We are waiting until he will expose himself. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Beautiful. He's about to blind fire me, so I want to escape from this bush, and look at this. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, he tried to blind fire me. Nice job, but not quite enough, buddy. Anyways, he's down to 200 hit points, and I'm waiting until he's going to escape from over there, but he won't. So what we are thinking immediately, how to outspot remaining of the enemy forces, and we are kind of ignoring this IS, because he's a dead meat, and I was the one who was spotting him. Great. Maybe they have some artists over there, and the answer is no. That's weird. Art with a keyboard, that's unusual, to be fair with you. Now, as you can see, there is a T-21, which is down to 2 shotable for us. Since we have extremely overpowered clip, we can simply eliminate him from the game, and now the real fun will start. Enemies have a lot of bushwhackers, and we have so many guns over there which is going to support us. It's insane. So this is already a great battle. Also, one more thing, fellas, in my opinion, this tank is one of the most overpowered tanks in the tier 7. It is insane how powerful it is, especially with a full gold, right? As you can see, this guy is melting. I mean, he's literally melting like ice cream in the hot summer day. By the way, fellas, I don't know, is it hot from your country, but I am making a YouTube video, then I am turning on AC for 20 minutes, and then I'm making another YouTube video, because it's that hot. It's insane what kind of summer do we have in Lithuania. Anyways, Speaking about the current situation, obviously we went super aggressively over there because we have a lot of support. We have the three Jeffs which is going to support us, and we have many, many, many guns which can support us too. We managed to hit him once and on the move, so that's great. And obviously he missed his shot over there, easy. There is five guns left. There is almighty bonus. Bonus is the tank which is getting ammo react all the time, and as you can see, bonus is getting spotted. Meanwhile, the other guy is trying to make a hardcore pressure for us, but we are already prepared for him and he is dead. Bonus down to 400 hit points, and my main goal and my initial plan is to go in front and to spot him for obvious reasons, because we have many, many, many guys which can actually support us, and all we need to do, we need to eliminate remaining enemy forces by shooting them or by alternatively spotting them for our team. As you can see, shit on of the auto aim right there, but it doesn't make any difference whatsoever because we can afford what we are doing right there. 6 kills, 2,400 assisting damage, and quite some blind damage dealt too. This is in effing sane game, okay? One more thing, fellas. I will allow you to guess what kind of base experience do we have with this vehicle after this battle. I want to see a lot of comments down below, and obviously if you are enjoying what you are seeing, feel free to like the video. It helps for a YouTube algorithm and it helps channel to grow, so I would appreciate that. Obviously, thank you so much for subscribing to the channel and for other goodies like patrons and for channel partnerships. I appreciate you and you are awesome, and you know it. Just because of you, I can say I'm living my dream. So everything is because of you, fellas. Thank you. So, boys and girls, that was the first battle. It was bloody perfection. Now let's go for a second game and let's see what we can craft there, right? Let's go. And we are back, boys and girls, with another replay right there. As you can see, in this battle, we are going to aim for damage, a raw damage. You are going to see the best battle which I managed to get with this tank, right? And how we are starting everything, we are going to the standard bush, which is Foxtrot 4. Why so? Because from this bush, you can pretty much counter what enemies are doing, right? By the way, we are doing some kind of stunts to make you proud of us. You know, I'm semi-goat, although I'm baboon, so please, stop it. Anyways, as you can see over there, boys, we are spotting all of those guys over there. We are spotting T20 going in front, T71 does sitting in the bush, and I'm simply waiting until enemies are going to do something bad. Although I decided to start shooting this T71 die, and this is not the smartest trades from my side, and I did not really want to take one for the team. Plus, on top of that, this T20 is thinking about making pressure on us, so that's definitely not the best idea. I'm getting proxy spotted over there, so I'm actually thinking about escaping, as you can see, for obvious reasons. But luckily this T20 did not have the best reaction time ever, so he did not manage it to punish us. Meanwhile, we got some assisting damage from this T20 over there, so that's very, very, very great stuff. Although he is making quite some pain for us, to be fair with you, fellas, and we are already one third of the hit points down, to be fair with you. So we need to figure out how to play this battle and how to get more use, because 600 as a start, it's not great for amount of the hit points which we lost over there. I'm thinking, can I blind fire this T71? Unfortunately, I did not manage to hit him, so that pretty much means he is not playing over there. Although, as you can see, T20 is making a hardcore pressure right there, and currently he is down to 2-shotable or 3-shotable for us. It's a matter of the seconds anyway, so it doesn't really matter because our alpha damage is so low anyways. And I'm thinking, maybe I want to push on him, or maybe he's going to do a mistake. The thing is, I don't want to make some stupidity myself in this kind of situation, because I am already way below the schedule in this battle in a way, right? Anyways, going into the same bush, and we managed to spot Sue over there. But first of all, we are thinking about this bush over there, checking, do they have anyone over there? They don't. So what that pretty much means, that means we have an open shot for this guy without bigger problems whatsoever. Obviously, I could wait a bit and wait until the HTC is going to hit him for 300 and then start clipping him, but oh well. I did what I did. Now score is looking so much better. It is a tier 7, fellas. Remember that. So we have 9 700 damage dealt and we have 800 assisting damage, so it's bringing us to 1,800 combined. This is a great performance. I mean, this is already okay score, right? It's not that bad, although we need 3,000 not to drop down at this point when we reach the third mark of excellence, so it's not easy by any means. Although we have met the T71 DA over there, we was using auto aim and we banged him like there is no tomorrow, and luckily this time we did not took one for the team, which is hip hip hooray for us. Score is 7-2, so what that basically means, we need to start thinking how to get maximum use of all this, otherwise we are going to have some problems. Meanwhile, Ikea is getting spotted and I'm... This tank is nasty, fellas. You can say whatever you want, but this vehicle can be nasty. 7 out of 8 shots, that was hip hip hooray, and now I'm thinking about the Hellcat over there. As you can see, Hellcat has 600 hit points and I'm setting auto aim. Since we have auto aim, all we need to do... Just like this. And now I know this is looking like quite a weird decision from our side to go over there and start shooting those guys which is playing around this area, but the answer is extremely simple. It's going to take some time till those guys from over there can approach them. So I am going for this side damage, and after that I am going to go to the other side. It's just, it is just greediness from my side in a way. I'm trying to get as much use as I physically and possibly can in this battle. As you can see, I'm trying to even craft a different angle over there in order to bang this prototype before it's too late, for obvious reasons, right? Because we want to get some more use over there. And this prototype, slowly but surely, he's going up, and I thought he's not going to hit me, but apparently prototype isn't going to hit me. I'm going on the reload and prototype is dead. Score 11-5. We are on 2,800 damage already and 1,600 resisting damage. This is already a great battle considering we have 4,500 and it is a tier 7. But we still have some time to play with. And as you can see, my prediction was correct, what I thought before, because I thought enemies are not going to be our allies. Are not going to be able to eliminate enemy forces from over there. And as you can see right here, beautiful, 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 beautiful tiger. Obviously we missed couple of shots to the left, couple of shots to the right, but I deserve this because I did not aim it too well. And plus, on top of that, I needed to start moving on him probably immediately right there. But oh well, no complaints, no regrets, fellas. We still want to get a bit of use right here. So we are obviously moving in front like there is no tomorrow. We are hitting the tiger and oh, bananas, fire, you lucky mother trucker with your fire. Whee! 34 hit points left, easy peasy, and we have 3 in the magazine. Now we have a plan. We cannot kill him from 3 in the magazine, but what we can do, we can hit him a couple of times and we can ram him to death. So are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Perfect finishing, solid, fellas, I repeat, solid 4,000 damage, solid 1,600 assisting damage, and it's bringing us up to 5,600 combined. That was a bloody epic battle, don't you think so? If this game do not deserve thumbs up, I don't know what does, okay? I'm not planning to strip for you yet, until I will create OnlyFans, okay? Thank you so much, fellas, thank you. Thank you, I appreciate those likes. And what we are going to do now, we are going to teleport on the third battle. So let's do this, fellas, easy peasy. And we are back, boys and girls. Teleportation skill worked just fine. Probably this is the third best battle. What we will be able to do here, we will be able to do a lot of damage, a lot of kills, and a lot of beautiful stuff. So stay tuned. In fact, this is my favorite tier 7 light tank in the game. I love this tank with all my heart, and there is no tank which can replace my heart. But I must admit, this tank is amazing with a gold ammunition once again. Without gold ammunition, with a standard 143 millimeters of penetration, it's not so good. Gold 195, so that's beautiful. And in the end of the day, why we are playing the game? Aren't we playing the game for fun, to enjoy ourselves, to have a blast, and to destroy others, which is trying to have a blast? Sure, that's what we are doing, fellas. Think about it. Anyways, what we did right here, we took the standard bush position over there, and we are simply knocked a couple of trees over there, so we will be protected from this side over there. Now pay attention, fellas, how the things is looking in this battle. This battle is looking like a big pile of poop for us. Why so? The quick explanation is very simple. There's three artists, which is in a way half of the trouble, because we are playing with the light tanks, but we do not have alpha damage with this vehicle. We cannot punish enemies. But what we can do, we can go in front and we can try to be naughty mother truckers over there, and we can try to punish everyone which is getting spotted right there. Meanwhile, we managed to spot our brother from other mother, and as you can see, he's going full bananas on us, and luckily he died. He managed to hit me only twice, but even though he hit us twice, he took like one third of the hit points already. But it doesn't matter, it's completely fine. I am feeling extremely good in this kind of situation for one particular reason. We have a lot of support over there. Meanwhile, the Škoda T25 is thinking about something very, very silly. And as you can see, Škoda is going in front like there is no tomorrow, and he is saying, "No, mother trucker, you will sing for me." And oh boy, I'm singing for him, fellas. Although he probably did not enjoyed this gaming experience himself, and he died. I lost 200 hit points and he lost his full hit points, so in a way it wasn't horrible traits. Look at this, another one. Type 64, eat caco. Okay, I'm trying to destroy some people right here. Look what you are doing. Anyways, as you can see, we managed to avoid the Type 64, so he did not want it to go on the full Trololo mode for us. So now what we want to do, we want to try to craft a better angle for this Type 58 for obvious reasons. And one for the team, two for the team, three for the team. I tried to go for a third one, but I'm not entirely sure did it hit. The score is looking 2-3, and there is still a lot of job to be done, fellas. Believe me, there is so much job to be done. It is insane for us, right? So what we are doing, we are avoiding this position over there, and now we want to kind of escape from this position, right? We don't want to play here anymore. Meanwhile, Panther is getting spotted. Panther, you know, you are very, very beautiful. I mean, I'm thinking about this Panther. Believe me, I am thinking about this guy, and unfortunately, I cannot outspot him from over there, but I still want to hit him. I have a feeling this guy is AFK, okay? And if I have feeling, 1, 2, 3... Beautiful. This guy is dead, and I went on the reload when Panther got spotted. It's okay. Let it be. Soon, fellas, we are going to reload fully, and then we can start banging this guy like there is no tomorrow. And let's start our journey. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whoever stolen the kill, you are going to burn in hell. Churchill, with all respect, you are going to burn in hell. We have 2,200 damage dealt, and we have 500 assisting damage, and we see the Tiger 131, which is traveling through the middle of the nowhere. I can tell you that this Tiger 131 is definitely not enjoying this his gaming experience, and as you can see, I'm not clicking shot by shot. When I am pushing this button, fellas, this tank is going non-stop like a bloody Uzi. This is exactly how this vehicle is going in the World of Tanks. I truly mean it, fellas. And this is probably one of the reasons why I like it. Anyways, what am I doing right here? Obviously, I'm making a hardcore pressure for this Mr. Excalibur, even though I knew the T-34-100 wasn't spotted, but we are just making some fun of this awkward tank over there, and we are running for our life like there is no tomorrow, and our clicker manager to secure the kill on the Mr. Excalibur. Meanwhile, this guy have 200 hit points left, and what we are thinking about, we are obviously thinking about spanking him in the ass, and sending him back to the garage. 1, 2, 3, he is dead. Hip hip hooray. And fellas, if there is a tank which is broken in the tier 7, I mean, call me an idiot, but I think this tank is broken. I don't know how else you could describe this vehicle if not broken, okay? I truly don't know how to do that. as you can see, 12T is inviting us for Brother in Arms, but I'm saying, no, I don't know. Maybe first of all, buy me a coffee before rigging Brother in Arms with me. Think about it. Maybe some coffee, or at least flowers, Kurva flowers, and I accepted Platoon, obviously, because he sent something special for me. Art is getting spotted in the right side over there. Obviously, we are trying to eliminate him from the game. He is dead, and we have 5 in the magazine. But we want to waste this 5 ammunition on this Lorraine. First miss, second hit, and the third hit over there. We have 5 kills, and we have only 2 shots in the magazine left. Guess what is happening in my head? Kill last guy with a last bullet. Kill last guy with a last bullet. This is what is happening in my head. But before that, we need to secure the kill on the Mr. Chrysler. And now this guy is pretty much doomed. I am thinking, do I want to shoot him? I don't want to shoot him. I want to shoot him. I don't want to shoot him. I don't run. This is literally what I thought, fellas. I'm just saying what I was thinking about. And now I'm thinking, do I want to steal him? I don't want to steal him. Do I want to steal him? I don't want to steal him. And the moment of truth, I noticed that the cover 2 is aiming for him. So I would rather get extra shot instead of not getting the extra shot and leaving with and being left with one ammunition left in our magazine. It's simply not worth it. So as you can see, that was a very, very strong battle, and I'm extremely happy with this performance which we managed to do right there. I mean, you can say whatever you want, boys and girls, but that was a great play. We read enemy team quite well. We did everything properly, and for real, fellas, I am extremely huge fan of this 1357. If I could pick one tank in the tier 7 which I love flawlessly, it wouldn't be E25, it wouldn't be T20, it wouldn't be anything else, it would be 1357, because amounts of the fun which I had was crazy. But everything is coming with a price. What do I mean by saying that is extremely simple. Even though I enjoyed playing with this vehicle, there was some things which was frustrating me quite a bit. And you might wonder, but skill, what things was frustrating you quite a bit? When we reached 97% of the mark of excellence, it was horrible gaming experience. What do I mean by saying that it was just horrible? Those were my last battles which I played with this tank. The last 100% mark game was in the ghost town. We did a lot of damage, some assisting damage, Redshire, a lot of damage, a lot of assisting damage, Erlenberg, quite some damage, quite some assisting damage, and that was the session. That's how we played with this vehicle. I mean, it was bloody insane, okay? And there was a fail over there, but we will pretend it never happened. Anyways, let's see the battles which we had right there. First of all, let's see the best spotting game which we had. I mean, we had in Malinovka a bit more spotting, but it's not even close. Look, compare this score, first class, 1.3 base experience, to this one. Fellas, you had to guess how much base experience we got. Schnei. 2,100 base experience. This battle is extremely rarely to happen. In order to get this kind of game, you need to do a lot of damage, you need to spot, you need to do everything. And we did everything properly in that battle. Even with this perfection, 17,000 minus. Noto. Okay, then moving on next. Speaking about the maximum damage game, this was maximum damage game, 4,100 damage, 1,600 assisting damage, 3 kills, and a flat 1,700 base experience with 55,000 minus. You need to pay a price for fun. And after that, we had Overlord Battle, where we managed to do 4,100 damage dealt, 800 assisting damage, 6 kills, 1,700 base experience, and as you can see, minus 65,000. That's insane. And speaking, is it my best base experience in the Rus server? Answer is yep, it is. It is my best base experience in the Rus server so far. So a big fat thumbs up for 1357. You are gorgeous, and you will always have a part in my heart. You are amazing, beautiful vehicle. And with that being said, now, fellas, what we need to do? We need to give some respect for this vehicle while I'm selling it. But skill, don't sell it. Flat million. money. Thank you so much for serving to our forces. See you next time. So, once again, next part is going to be with this vehicle, with this kind of loadout, best of, and we will compare stats and we will see how better I played with last tank compared to this one without full gold loadout, right? And the goal is going to be the same, to get up to 100% of Mark of Excellence. Thank you so much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one and see you very, very, very soon. Peace.